Hold on. Okay, we are good. Okay, just double check it. What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Phil Shocker, that I see Tedjog here with our LPL Week 3 matchup here, going against the Lottie God here. You guys don't know, I've actually faced off with Lottie God here two times in the Speed Tour, and he has crushed me at both times because he's had broken Pokemon on his team in the Speed Tour. So he's got more of a broken team this time around, so let's quickly give you guys a team matchup here, and I obviously don't mind spoiling this because this is going to be a week in advance. And you'll obviously see this before you see any of these videos going up. But we actually made some changes to the team. I will discuss those changes after the matchup. But this is his team. He has Reshiram, Ursaluna. And Ursaluna, Ghost, Arceus, this and that. And this is going to be our team here. Assault Vested, Palkia, which is designed to pretty much just take some hits. Rock Tomb for speed control. We have a 3 attacks offensive Arceus Bug. Sheer Force, Rock Polish, Slanderous Eye, which basically starts putting in work once we get a speed boost going. Togekiss, which is sub 3 attacks with leftovers, just kind of be a defensive pivoting, defensive breaking of the team right here. Hopefully get some ancient power boost. Can kind of really put in the work there. We have Metagross, which is just 4 attacks offensive. Grass Knot into about everything else does that. And Assault Vested Skazer here, just be able to take hits regardless of the matchup here. So with that being said, let's go ahead and challenge the Lottie God. We fix that. He brought exactly what I was, actually, he did not bring exactly. He didn't bring Reshiram. Wow. That is actually kind of surprising that he did not bring Reshiram. I was so predicting Reshiram. I did not expect that is a shock to me, actually. And of course, my. Doesn't bring. And he doesn't bring Zapdos! Ooh. And Earth Power is a hunt. Once I set up a Rock Polish, I basically. Ooh. We are looking pretty good here. I actually like leading off with my Drapion here. Perfect. Oh, the song is playing right now. It's fire. Dun, 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 dun. Also, guys, well, you know, I changed this team like 3 times when I made those trades. So, yeah, but I'll get into a little bit more detail after the video. But for right now, let's focus on this matchup here. Because I would like to get a chance to get a win here. We really need to get a win here. Wow, this knockoff does no damage. Does that knockoff really say that right there? That it doesn't do any damage? Alright, I'm gonna knock off, see how much that actually does. Yeah, it only does 34%. Go in my Landorus now. Earth Power just 51 to 60%. I go into my Palkia. Spatial Ren's a 2-shot. He could click recover here. I'm gonna Centaur. I need to keep Skazer slightly healthy. Does our power. Now what I could do here. Since he doesn't have a resist, I'm just gonna click Spatial Red. Or do I click Surf here? And then click space to run, because... I could switch for red. There's no reason not to. He does recover, so he does reveal, so it's a speed tie at the very least. Monster here. We do catch Glow King. Do a crit, which is very unfortunate. Now, are you gonna reveal Trick Room to me, or are you gonna reveal... does this thing learn teleport? It does not learn teleport, so... You either click Slack Off, or Trick Room here. Glow King. The 31%. Yeah, that's assault vested. I'm gonna risk it going to my Scouser here. That's future side. Okay. I think I just click knock here again. Or do I click Earthquake, predicting the Lucario to come in and try to get a Justify boost? I'm gonna click Earthquake. Arceus comes in. I'm gonna click Knock here again. If anything, I'm forcing him to waste his recovers here. I'm going to go with Cientos here. Judgment. Max special attack. Timid. Oh, that's with my Palkia. With my Togekiss. I want to see if he's going to reveal something to me here. Oh, let's go, baby. I'm going to click Surf here. I'm gonna switch into my Metagross here. I'm gonna take Meteor Mash here. Actually, hold on. Oh, you know what I should have done? I should not have made that thing minus special attack nature. Ooh. He's definitely not Spadef. Meteor Mash would have done 25%. He's definitely Fizz, though. Yeah, so this knot's a roll to kill. If I'm him, I just sack Swampert here. There's no reason not to keep this thing alive. So that meter mash, how much does that do? Maybe 18. Actually, I just click mash here, actually. Actually, no, I click Grickrink here. This does reveal pretty much... It does not reveal ever. By clicking Brick Break here, I catch the Lucario skill, and I catch Greninja. In case he somehow saves this, which I highly doubt he's going to save this. If he does, that's going to be very interesting. He does save it. I am very confused by that. I'm just going to click Mash here, though. Don't let him get a free chance to set up here. I don't think he has Ice Beam, so I'm going to Rock Polish up here. He does have Ice Beam. Fuck. Yeah, we're going to lose. That's GG. Well, that's unfortunate. We get 6-0'd. I honestly think that was a misplay on him, though. Like, honestly, I don't think you save... You don't save... Swampert. I just feel like you don't save Swampert there. That makes kind of no sense to save Swampert. In my honest opinion, I don't think you save Swampert. Alright, this is just gonna be a stall fest now. Yeah, I'm gonna lose 6-0, dude. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I don't know if it's just the format or something, but... I feel like I'm just doing something wrong. I don't know what it is, but I'm doing something wrong. And, yep, that just guaranteed it now. That just guaranteed I lost. Surf is doing enough, right? Yeah, Surf does enough. If he's got priority, he just clicks it. Dude, come on! Dude, come on. I'm just gonna end the match there. I'm generally very frustrated because he stalled out that endgame when that endgame really didn't matter right there. Like, he legitimately won. If he wanted to, like, I don't know why he went into Slow King there. I honestly, if he wanted to click recovery at least one time, that's fine. But that stalling at the end was extremely unnecessary for my opponent's end. And again, I personally don't agree with saving Swampert. I really don't agree with that. That makes no sense to me. So save Swampert. It legitimately makes no sense to save Swampert. Because Swampert, what is Swampert doing for you in this matchup? Nothing. He does nothing. So I'm very incredibly frustrated that he purposely played for the 6-0. Like, I hate that. I'm not gonna lie to you. I really hate that when people do that on purpose. Like, this is just a game. This is not meant to be super competitive. This is not meant to, you know, let's humiliate all our opponents and just try to go for 6-0 wins and stuff like that. Like, obviously, at the end of the day, we are playing a competition to try to win, but it doesn't need to be played like that, like, for purpose of purposely getting a 6-0. Like, I don't care if an opportunity is there. Like, I won't lie. I have played for 6-0s before in the past. And in my one game in NBA, I did play for the 4-0, but because I saw the opportunity because I knew I could win with the 4-0. So that's why I went for it. Otherwise, I really don't care about differential. And I think a lot of times people just care way too much about the differential there. So, Lottie, if you were watching this, just know I'm not really upset, dude. I just didn't really want that end game to be stalled out for no reason. Because that end game legitimately did not need to be stalled out right there. If anything, you just go ahead, sack Swampert. You sack Swampert, bring in Arceus Ghost. If you want to click recover at least one time to scout damage and then, you know, go from there, it's fine. But I didn't have Roost, so... just to give you guys a refresher, again, this thing was meant to take hits. This thing was to attack offensive. This did that. The original team I had, honestly, I don't think it would have done anything else different, really. To be honest. Well, maybe, I don't know. It could have, it could not, you never know. But yeah, that's the team. If I wasn't my special attack nature, I would have gotten rid of that Swampert a lot earlier, and I would have been a more full health Metagross. So, that's a little on me there, because I didn't change that. I should have made sure that was not my special attack nature, so... But I'll quickly go over the transactions we made here real quick. So first off, we traded away Sogaleo and Zamazenta. So we did drop those, traded those away. I honestly didn't know. I wanted Mega Metagross, to be honest, as my Steel type for the beginning of this draft. So if anything, I swapped my Steel Psychics around. Now, arguably, you could say that, you know, probably Sogaleo is better because of the fact that it has a better HP stat. In terms of also having better special attack and having make usage of it. But regardless, I think Metagross was better because it gave me that 110 speed cheer, which I really need. Gave me a bit of a more physically defensive and especially defensive and still a stronger attacker overall as well. So overall, I think the trade was a little bit fair and slightly better in my end. Plus, I do love Mega Metagross. I've used this thing before. It's definitely not that bad of a Mega and better of an Uber as well. So I was really excited to try that. Then I traded away Dawnwing's Necrozma. No, Zamazenta for Dawnwing's Necrozma. And this is where I was kind of stupid, but I was like, you know what, I'll just do it. So, Dawnwing's, I've used Dawnwing's before, and I've actually had some fun with it in Uber's League, but I left that league because it was dead and no one cared about it anymore. So, trading away for Zama definitely, I think, was kind of a bit of a mistake because of the fact that I gave up that much speed in terms of the offense I could add to my team. But Dawnwing's, he can provide a Trick Room option for this team, so it's all overall, I don't think, not the worst decision out there. Plus, I think it's really good defensively, and has some insane offense for special attack. Plus, I kind of really need some special attackers on my team, which I think is really necessary. And lastly, I dropped Mega DNC for Licky Licky, but then said trade Licky Licky to pick up Togekiss. I needed to make sure I replaced my Fairy type, which is really important. And now I get another mon that's actually a defogger for the team. So it's a mon that can reliably run defog this week. Plus, I've won a championship with Togekiss run the first run of the... I've won two championships with Togekiss. So Togekiss is a mon I know very well and can actually have some a lot of fun with. But overall, I think it was really, really nice. So it's just a nice little unique mon. So yeah, those are the three transactions I have made for my draft. So I'm... obviously didn't get a chance to prove himself. Look, to be fair though, I was rebuilding my team, like three to two members, legitimately. Because originally on the build, I didn't have Drapion on the build, but then I put Dawnwing's, Togekiss, this because I had to get rid of Zom because I didn't think my transactions were gonna imply my match against Lottie because I had already built for Lottie, but Sceptile. Told me that since I made those trades, they're active for this week. And I even said that I already had scheduled Lottie. We said, no, they're active for your week. But then they were trying to go back a lot. But then they said, never mind. Just focus on that using the new trades. So I ended up screwing myself. But at the same time, I felt like I was getting screwed out of not using the mons I had already built with. since I already did build for my week 3 game and had planned to play it the day of. And plus, I don't think it was going to be fair to make, you know, Lottie have to rebuild his team as well. So you can say I'm being very salty and saying it's someone's fault by that he gets to use the original team, which, fair enough, is to say that the original team may have still lost. We never know, and we probably will never know now. So, regardless, though, again, I'm not going to be mad. I'm just really mad how that endgame went, just from stalling out the turns when they were unnecessary turns. Like, the Slow King, unnecessary. Now bringing Arceus in, recovering like 2 or 3 times, unnecessary. Like, I even if I had Roost, I wasn't going to click Roost because I was not going to draw out that game because there was no way I was going to win. The only way I was going to win is by literally flinch-axing my opponent. So there was no way I was going to be able to beat his team. Plus, Lucario, if it's Meteor Mash plus Bullet Punch, it basically just kills me regardless. So it's no point in trying to stall at the bat. And plus, I can't stall out Arceus unless I can and I get crit or frozen. By that point in time, I either get crit so many times or I freeze so many times to the point where he's going to get the win. So honestly, I didn't want to strike out the game. Even if I had Roost, I'm not clicking. I was not going to probably click it unless I saw opportunities to click it for free. But regardless, I just didn't really like how he stalled out that end game where it was not really necessary to stall out the match. So I'm just frustrated by that. I should have definitely changed my Metagross so it wasn't my special attack nature. That's definitely on me on that one. 100%. But yeah, I don't know what else to say. That's the transactions, by the way, I was going to talk about. And that's just been our week this week. The video is definitely going to be dragged out for quite a long way. So if you guys watch all the way to the end, thank you. And again, there's going to be no hate sent to either Sep or Lottie here. Obviously, Sep made the rule that those go in the play immediately. So that should be on me not to talk to him and try to make sure I can use these ones for week 2. Because I would have been fair to Lottie and not have to force him to reprep some of his mons. Because he probably reprepped because of the fact that I made those changes. And I didn't think that was going to be fair to Lottie unless Lottie didn't care. I mean, Lottie didn't care, then Lottie didn't care. But I didn't want to be that type of guy that, you know, forced him to reprep, so I was going to be fine using my old team. And I think I should have technically used my, because I already confirmed that we were going to play on Monday, which is the day you're seeing this record. Well, not the day we were going to be recording, but the day we played this game. So I think, in fairness, I should have played with my old team instead of my new team. Lottie, I mean, again, I'm only really mad at him just for stalling out that endgame. I think the endgame was not necessarily stalled out. And you guys know I just hate stalling. Like, I hate, like, even something like that. I hate a game that gets just stalled just to that point degree. It's just very frustrating and very annoying, and I just don't really like that. So, I also don't agree that he should have saved Swampert. He only saved Swampert just so he can purposely hit 6-0. Lottie, in the future, dude, just let things die, man. I understand you were trying. I think you were purposely not trying to 6-0, but then you just saw the opportunity and just went for it. I'm going to let everyone know, don't play for differential. It's just stupid to play for differential. Even if you see a viability, just don't. It's just stupid to play for it. Because you're making someone feel bad that they lost so badly. You know, it just hurts. So I'm not going to try to rant anymore. I'm just going to end this video. If you stayed all the way to the end, you're very appreciated and you're very respectable. I love you all. Thanks so much, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.